ABCD, I will take these three numbers as ABC. So this is A, this is B, and this is C. The question is ABC are in which progression? So given that A square, B square, C square are in AB. So whenever there exists 2B square, I can write A square plus C square, because that is the condition for AP. Now once you see these numbers, what is A plus B plus C? What is A plus B plus C? Tan X minus tan X cancelled, minus tan Y plus tan Y cancelled, minus tan Z plus tan Z cancelled. Therefore you will get A plus B plus C is equal to 0. And therefore B is equal to, or A plus C is equal to minus B. A plus C is equal to minus B. And squaring on both sides. So A square plus C square plus 2AC is equal to B square. And what is A square plus C square here? 2B square. Right, Dutch? 2B square plus 2AC is equal to B square. That implies 2B square minus B square. B square is equal to minus 2AC. See, here only you have to observe. B square is nothing but B into B. So 1B can be written in the denominator. So minus 2AC by B. So B square is B into B. So if you divide with B, you will get only 1B here. We get 1B here. Okay. If I write that minus in the denominator, in place of minus B, I can write A plus C. So this implies B is equal to 2AC by A plus C. So what is the condition, Dutch? If 2B is equal to A plus C, ABC are in AP. If B square is equal to AC, ABC are in GP. If B is equal to 2AC by A plus C, they are in HP, harmonic progression. So these numbers are in harmonic progression. So right there.
Excuse me, sir. Sir, in which page this problem is there, sir? I could not find it.
Page number 43, example 5.
Yes.
Now ask me if you have any doubts. First, Rahul.
This Rahul, problem is okay, sir. I want to example 7.
Okay. We will do.
Okay, sir.
Harshavardhan.
Sir.
Any doubt?
No, sir.
Sneha. Sneha. Okay. Right. So see, Rahul Roy is asking 7th question. So tan theta is equal to n into tan phi. Then the maximum value of tan square theta minus phi. What is the maximum value of tan square theta minus phi? That is the question. So first we will find tan theta minus phi. If you square that, you will get tan square theta minus phi. So what is tan square tan theta minus phi? That is tan theta minus tan phi by 1 plus tan theta tan phi. So what is the simplification? So in place of tan theta, I can write tan phi. Therefore, n tan phi minus tan phi by 1 plus, in place of tan theta, I can write tan phi into tan phi. That is the first step. Now we will divide numerator and denominator with the tan phi. Therefore, here you will get n minus 1 by 1 by tan theta, tan phi, plus n into 1 tan phi is cancelled, you will get only 1 tan phi. So what is that step? Divide with the tan phi. Okay. Now this is equal to n minus 1 by, what is 1 by tan phi? Part phi. Plus n tan phi. So see now, if consider that cot phi plus n tan phi, apply the formula, arithmetic mean greater than or equal to geometric mean. So that is, the two numbers are, one is cot phi and the other one is n tan phi, not only tan phi, n tan phi. So a plus b by 2 greater than or equal to root ab, that is n into cot phi into tan phi is 1, no need to write that. Therefore, so cot phi plus n tan phi greater than or equal to 2 root n. But it is in the denominator, so reverse this. So if you reverse this, what happens? Inequality will be reversed. That is, greater than becomes less than. So 1 by 2 root n. And in next step, what I will do? There is n minus 1. So multiply with n minus 1 both sides. It must be positive. So they will give condition, don't worry about that. Less than or equal to n minus 1 by 2 root n. So it's over. So this is n minus 1 by cot phi into tan plus tan phi, less than or equal to this. So this is nothing but this one. But we need tan square theta minus phi. So we write this square. So the final step is tan square theta minus phi less than or equal to n minus 1 whole square by 4n. Now see the options, if the options are there, or here it is worked out example, so they won't give options, just give the results. So it is less than or equal to n minus 1 whole square by 4n means maximum value is n minus 1 whole square by 4n. Okay. Sai Shankar. Okay, so let us do 11th question. So all these are questions only, difficult only. So don't worry if you don't get them. These are difficult. So the best prop, the best book to practice fundamental concepts and the first practice book will be definitely IPE book. IPE. So no doubt, it is the first book. So everyone should buy those books, IPE. It will have two volumes, 1A and 1B, Telugu Academy books. Telugu Academy books. So for your intermediate examinations, so you should definitely, you should buy and you have to practice them. So those are fundamental books. Okay. After that, so then you can comfortably do the problems, somehow problems in this Narayana material. Okay. If you can do 90% problems comfortably in Telugu Academy books, definitely you can do more than 50% comfortably in exercise 1 and exercise 2. Okay, they are designed like that. And so from exercise 3, the problems are somewhat difficult. Okay, and what Akash wants to... Akash?
Sir, due to some internet connection, I joined now. Sir, what you taught till now?
Akash?
Hello. Hello, sir.
Akash?
Hello, sir.
So, sir, what is it out?
Sir, I due to internet connection, I joined now, sir. Can you tell what you taught, sir, till now?
Just we have done only some 3 problems, that's all. Okay?
Sir, what you was telling about IP exam, sir?
No, not about IP exam. So, first do problems in Telugu Academy books.
Okay, sir.
So, okay. So, see, 11th problem. F of theta is equal to 1 by 1 plus cot theta whole power x and s is equal to summation theta is equal to 1 degree to 89 degrees f of theta. So, what is the value of square root of 2s minus h? So, that is the question. So, what is s actually? This is s. What is s? If you substitute theta 1, f of 1 plus f of 2 plus so on, f of 89 degrees. So, that is the sum. Now, what is f of 1 in place of theta? If you write 1, you will get f of 1. Okay? Now, we will do one thing. I am interested in f of 90 minus theta. What is this? 1 by 1 plus cot in place of theta, I have to write 90 minus theta. 1 by 1 plus cot 90 minus theta is tan theta. Tan theta can be written as 1 by cot theta. So, 1 by 1 plus 1 by cot theta power x. So, that is equal to cot theta power x by cot theta power x plus 1. Okay. So, this is f of 90 minus theta. So, here crucial result is, if you add these two, what happens? So, there are so many term sums like that. That's why I am observing what happens to this sum. So, what is f of theta? This one. What is f of 90 minus theta? This one. Both have same denominator. So, that is the LCM. 1 plus cot theta whole power x. And the numerator is here is 1. And the denominator here is, numerator here is cot theta power x. And these two are cancelled. You will get 1. Therefore, f of theta plus f of 90 minus theta is 1. That means f of 1 plus f of 90 minus 1, 89 degrees. That is 1. So, f of 2 plus f of 90 minus 2, 88 degrees. So, that is also 1. So, like that. So, here you see f of 1, f of 89. That sum is 1. F of 2 plus f of 88. That sum is 1. F of 3 plus f of 87. That sum is 1. Plus so on. You will get up to f of 44 plus f of 46. That is also 1. So you will get like that 44 terms. But there is a single term left alone. What is that? F of 45. F of 45. There is no another F of 45. Only 145 is there. So, 1 plus 1 plus 1 44 times means 44. Plus what is F of 45 here? Substitute. Cot 45 is 1. 1 power x is 1. 1 plus 1 2. 1 by 2. So, this is 1 by 2. So, you got S. 88 plus 1. 89 by 2. And that is nothing but S. Now, you have to simplify this. 2 into S. 89. Minus 8, 81. It's a square root. The answer is 9. Madam, so important one. Okay. Right. Any doubts? See, 13th question, X, Y, Z, T are real numbers. Such that X square plus Y square is equal to 9. Z square plus T square is equal to 4. X T minus Y Z is equal to 6. And now the question is, what is the greatest value of XZ? So greatest value of XZ. See, because it is given in this chapter, so we look about trigonometric functions. But actually there is no single trigonometric function in this problem. That means this is an application of trigonometric chapter. Okay. So X, Y, Z, T are real numbers. Now X square plus Y square is equal to 9. See, I can take X is equal to 3 cos theta. Y is equal to 3 sin theta. Now can I take like that? So this is 9 cos square theta. This is 9 sin square theta. So by adding you will get 9 only. Similarly, Z is equal to 2 cos alpha, that may be another angle, that need not be this angle. So T is equal to 2 sin alpha. By squaring and adding you will get only 4. And not only that, given another information, that is HT minus YZ is equal to 6. What is X? What is T? This one, this into this. So 6 into sin alpha into cos theta minus this into this. 6 into sin theta into cos alpha is equal to 6. Now you can cancel 6 both sides by dividing with 6. So this is nothing but sin alpha cos theta minus cos alpha sin theta. That is sin alpha minus theta. So that is equal to what? So there is 1. That means alpha minus theta is equal to what? 90 degrees. So sin x is equal to 1 means x is equal to 90 degrees. So that implies alpha is equal to theta plus pi by 2. So the question is, what is the greatest value of xz? What is x? This. What is z? This. So 6 into cos theta into cos alpha. 6 into cos theta into cos alpha. Right? Now right here. So that xz is equal to, so 6 into cos theta into, what is alpha? Theta plus pi by 2. Cos theta plus pi by 2. That is minus sin theta. So this is minus 3 into 2 sin theta cos theta. That is sin 2 theta. So what is the maximum value of sin theta? Sin 3 theta, that is nothing but 1. What is minimum value of sin 3 theta? Minus 1. Therefore, its maximum value is 3 into 1, that is 3. Therefore, the greatest value of this function is 3. Better? Nikhil, any doubts? Nikhil?
16th answer.
Okay, okay. So let me first explain some roots of the equations. So roots of the equations, what is that? Now you know every quadratic equation has two roots. So let x1 comma x2 be the roots. And what is the formula for sum of the roots? X1 plus x2 is equal to minus b by a. So it is minus of quotient of x by quotient of x square. And next product, x1 x2 is equal to c by a. X1 x2 is equal to c by a. So you know that. And now about cubic equation, ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus b is equal to 0. So because it is a cubic equation, it should have three roots. So whether they may be real or not, but the roots must be three. X1, x2, x3 be the roots. And what is the formula for sum of the roots? That is x1 plus x2 plus x3. That is minus b by a. And what is product of the roots? Sum of the products taken two at a time. So this is sum of the products taken two at a time. So that is c by a. And what is product of the roots? X1, x2, x3. So once again, that is minus, minus constant term by quotient of x cube. Minus b by a. So write them. So write them. Using that, we will do a problem. Pritham? Pritham, any doubts?
Sir, for example, if you have an equation like ax per 100 plus bx per 99 like that, the sum of roots will be minus b by only, sir.
So whatever may be the quadratic, is it quadratic equation you are saying?
No, sir. Like ax per 100 plus bx per 99 like that.
Ax power 100?
Yes, sir.
Okay, ax power 100 plus
bx per 99.
Plus x power 98, 90, and so on, so on, so on. So, how many roots are there for this?
100, sir.
So, every polynomial equation of nth degree has n roots. Therefore, definitely, so here there will be 100 roots, and some of the roots will be, no doubt, as you said, minus b by a. Okay?
Sir, and product of roots?
So, no doubt. So, product of roots, just you observe here.
Last term, sir.
Here, what is product of the roots? C by A. Here, what is the product of the roots? Minus B by A. In both of these, denominator is quotient of the highest power, no doubt. In both of these, numerator is constant term, that is also no doubt. But here you got plus, here you got minus. So, how to remember this? If the power is even number, you will get plus. And the power is odd number, you get minus. Okay.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
So now you tell me now. Suppose I will write this one fourth degree, not up to 100th degree, it is not necessary for us also. So ax power 4 plus bx cube plus cx square plus dx plus e is equal to 0. So how many roots are there?
4, sir.
4. Let them be x1, x2, x3, x4. So I have laziness to write all of them. So to write the sum, simply I will write sigma xi. So I is equal to 1, 2, 4. That is nothing but x1 plus x2 plus x3 plus x4. So tell me, what is the answer now?
Minus b by a.
B by a. And now sum of the products taken two at a time. Simply I will write like this. Xi, xj. That is x1, x2 plus x1, x3 plus x1, x4 plus x2, x3, plus x2, x4, plus x3, x4. So all of those 6 I have to write here. That means 1 less than or equal to I, less than or equal to j, less than or equal to 4. But I should not be equal to j. I am not taking x1 into x1 like that. What is this product? Some of the products taken 2 at a time. That is nothing but c by a. And what is some of the products taken 3 at a time? Xi, xj, xk like that. And once again, minus d by a. And finally, product of the roots, x1, x2, x3, x4 is e by a. So what we are observing is, product of the roots for even power is just e by a, there is no minus. Therefore, as we asked in the previous example, x power 100, that is even power. Therefore, product of the roots is simply constant term by quotient of x power 100. Okay, Pritha?
So thank you, sir.
Right, right. So if we have enough time, how we got this, why we got this also, we can see. But actually, already you have learned all this in your earlier classes. Right, see then, using that, there is a problem, sixth problem. Tan alpha, tan beta, tan gamma are the roots of x cube minus 3x square minus r is equal to 0. So what are the roots? Tan alpha, tan beta, tan gamma. So I can write the sum. What is the sum of the roots? Minus of minus p by 1. And what is the sum of the products taken 2 at a time? This one. And see, what is that? What is this? There is no x term here. Therefore, there is no sum of the products taken 2 at a time. That becomes 0. And what is product of the roots? Tan alpha, tan beta, tan gamma. So what is product of the roots? Minus of minus plus r by 1. That is r. And now what is the question? To find the value of 1 plus tan square alpha into 1 plus tan square beta into 1 plus tan square gamma. Now if you expand this, what you will get? You will get 1 plus tan square alpha plus tan square beta plus tan square gamma plus tan square alpha tan square beta plus tan square beta tan square gamma plus tan square gamma tan square alpha. You will get easily this product sum. So this is tan square alpha, tan square beta, tan square gamma. So that sum you will get. Now you have to simplify this. Out of this, I know this immediately. So what is that? Tan alpha, tan beta, tan gamma whole square. So what is this? So this is nothing but it's a square. R square. That is R square. And to find this, I will write this formula, a plus b plus c whole square, a square, so sigma t alpha square, that's 2 into sigma t alpha t beta, I can write like that. So this is nothing but t, so it is t square, so this I need, sigma t alpha square, and this is 0. So that is 0. Therefore, sigma t alpha square means t square alpha plus t square beta plus t square gamma is equal to p square. See, in this expression, I got this one and also I got this one. And now I have to find this. To find that, I am writing x square tan alpha tan beta plus tan beta tan gamma plus tan gamma tan alpha whole square, AB plus BC plus CA whole square. You can observe that it becomes sigma tan square alpha tan square beta plus 2 tan alpha tan beta tan gamma into tan alpha plus tan beta plus tan gamma. So you observe, you take after the completion of this class, you take AB plus BC plus CA whole square. What happens, you observe, you will get A square B square plus B square C square plus C square C square plus 2ABC into A plus B plus. And now I know this one, this is nothing but 0. Is equal to sigma, I need this, plus 2 product or sum P. And therefore, sigma P square alpha P square beta is equal to minus 2RP. So, I got everything. So, I'll substitute here. See. So, that is equal to 1 plus, and this is nothing but P square. And this is nothing but minus 2RP. And this is just I have erased that is R square. So that is equal to 1 plus P minus R whole square. Madam. Any doubts? Okay, so somebody asked a 16th problem. Actually, I think I have done this, but we'll do once again. It's a good problem. Cos beta minus gamma plus cos gamma minus alpha is equal to minus 3 by 2. And what about sigma cos alpha, sigma sin alpha? So we did this or not? Now tell me. So Rahul can say. Rahul?
Sir.
Rahul, we have done this or not?
Yes, sir.
Previously I did this, na?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Okay, see. So we did this, of course, we'll do once again, just he's asked. But always keep your notes with you, so that you know whether you have done that problem or not. So every day read the formulae, and every day, so read the notes once. Now if you find difficulty in any problem, just you put a star mark. So you need not for Sunday examination or for Saturday examination, if you want to read the notes, if you want to study the notes, or if you want to do the problems in the notes, you can't do every problem. Therefore, while doing only, you can observe whether it is difficult or not. Suppose if you feel difficult, so you put star mark. Okay. Suppose you want to ask some doubts, then there is some doubt. So D for doubt. Suppose in those 10 steps, so what actually happens in the classroom, in the study hours in Narayana College is like that. Suppose you are reading or you are doing the problem or you are observing the problem. there are 10 steps. So in the fifth step, there is doubt. Now you put a star mark. And after completion of the class, in study hours, you will come. So what about this fifth step? So I didn't understand this one. Like that. But there is no facility here. Now you can ask at any time. Because here, there will be some waste of time. Because there are 100 students. Just only one student do not know a problem, do not know, understand, do not understand a problem. But 99 students can do that problem very well. So it is a waste of time for me. So no problem. So here important one. See the magic here. In IP examination, what is the difference between IP and this computer examination? See, in IP examination, he will give that sigma cos alpha is equal to 0 and sigma sin alpha is equal to 0. So see the difference. In the IP examination, standard descriptive examinations, he will give these two are 0. That is cos alpha cos beta plus cos gamma is equal to 0. Sin alpha sin beta plus sin gamma is equal to 0. And he asks, what about this? What is cos alpha minus beta plus cos beta minus gamma plus cos gamma minus alpha? What is the value of that? The answer will be minus 3 by 2. How you will get? Simply, because this is 0, cos alpha plus cos beta, see, cos alpha plus cos beta plus cos gamma whole square plus sin alpha plus sin beta plus sin gamma whole square is also 0. 0 square plus 0 square. If you expand this, you will easily get the results. Cos square alpha plus sin square alpha 1, cos square beta plus sin square beta 1, cos square gamma plus sin square gamma 1, plus 2 cos alpha cos beta plus 2 sin alpha sin beta, 2 cos alpha minus beta, plus 2 cos beta minus gamma, plus 2 cos gamma minus alpha is 0. And now what will be the question? What is the value of this? That will be the question. Then what you will do? So 2 into cos alpha minus beta plus cos beta minus alpha plus cos gamma minus alpha is, the next step it becomes minus 3 here, and after that it will be minus 3. So no doubt, crystal clear. So you can understand the problem very well. But what about in the competitive examination? They will ask the reverse process. So that is somewhat difficult for us.